Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Prestige. Today, we're going to be unboxing another Call of Duty box, another World War II box. This is not the same one that I unboxed last week. The last one I did was called the Deployment Kit. This one's actually found at Walmart for $30. And the thing is, I couldn't find it at my local Walmart. I couldn't find it at the other Walmart. So I decided to have one of my friends pick it up, and they shipped it to me. So thank you so much, JP, for shipping it over to where I'm at. But as you can clearly see, we got some stuff going on here. We have an art print, a wallet, dog tags, a canteen with an insulated case, a journal with a pen, and a fold-away backpack. And then at the bottom it says, exclusive mystery collectible. $30 at Walmart, and it contains a lot of the same stuff that was within the deployment kit. So let's go ahead and cut off this plastic and open this thing up together. All right, now we got the plastic off. We're just gonna go ahead and take off this little side piece that holds the box together. This kind of reminds me of a loot crate. You guys remember loot crate? This reminds me of a loot crate, and it's a nice harder style cardboard, so you could technically keep the box if you wanted to, but I really wouldn't recommend that. All right, this is built by Culturefly. Culturefly is a company that's similar to Loot Crate, I'm guessing, but it looks like the stuff in here is actually pretty high quality. Let's take a look at the canteen first off. So this is not like the canteen from the deployment kit. This is a plastic canteen. It still can get the job done, though. I mean, if you wanted to put some liquid in here, you definitely could. The canteen itself, once again, it's not metal or steel like the deployment kit, so it's a little bit of a lesser quality, which is okay, I suppose. And it's got the Allied Forces right there. And unfortunately, there's no belt loop either, so this doesn't really stick to anything. Next up, we have the field journal. Let me go ahead and get this out of the bag. This is a pretty interesting journal. Let's go ahead and open it up, see what's inside. It's almost like a little binder of sorts. These actually can come apart similar to like school binders. So if you needed a piece of paper or something like that, you could do that. And the outside says World War II, and the backside has, of course, the Allied Forces, the US Army star. And I guess you just kind of wrap it up by doing this and folding it across, but pretty cool nonetheless. Got a little bit of a silica gel. You know how that goes. Let's go ahead and check out this bag here. The bag itself is a lot higher quality than I imagined. Oh, it's like a backpack almost. It's got the star once again. On the inside, you got a case number, and it's almost like one of those zip bags on the inside. There's lots of room for stuff. This could be good for carrying books and things like that, or maybe if you were going to spend a night at a friend's house, it could be used as an overnight bag, but for the most part, this is pretty self-explanatory. Next up in here, we have the wallet, which I am actually interested in because I have not upgraded my wallet since Call of Duty Black Ops 3. And this wallet is really small. I don't know if I'm going to be able to use it. There's actually no room for money, which is kind of weird. There's no pockets or anything. It's literally just for cards. I guess we're really going into the digital age, huh, guys? We're really going into the digital age. Either way, though, it looks really nice. It's got World War II on the front. I don't really know how to feel about this wallet. There's no room for money unless you put, like, a clip or something in here, or you fold the money up and you stick it in the top and fold it in. I know a lot of people have just switched over to using straight up cards, but still, it'd be nice to have a little pocket. I guess you could put a clip in there, but either way, we'll throw that off to the side. Let's take a look at this pen because it looks really weird, actually. I've never seen a pen like this before. So the pen is all plastic, and I don't really know how to feel about this pen either. It's a nice pen. I'm gonna have to see how it writes. We'll check that out in just a moment. Let's go ahead and write on this Culturefly. Oh, okay, it's like a gel pen. I like gel pens. Works pretty nice. It gets A+ from me on the writing side. Next up in the box, we have this limited edition print, which is of course the same as the calling card that you can get if you get the hardened edition or the premium edition Prima Game Strategy Guide, the special edition. This is what the calling card looks like in-game. And I'll put a little overlay on the screen so you can check it out as well. But once again, the calling card doesn't come with this box. That comes with the strategy guide. It looks nice. It's small. It could be part of a collage, and that's pretty much all I can really think of at this point. The dog tags aren't bad, actually. It's a very thin type of material. For the sake of science, I'm going to bend this. So, yeah, that kind of gives you an idea of how flimsy the material is. It's not terrible, but they're not directed towards anybody. It just says Call of Duty World War II, and of course it's got the star on there. And finally, we have the collectible coin. This must be what was inside. It's actually one of my favorite pieces of this box is this collectible coin. It's not that heavy, to be honest, but it does look pretty nice. And if you're a collector, I guess you could add this to your collection. So let's go and review everything that's in here. You get the collectible print, which is nice and tiny. I guess you could hang it up on a wall or something like that. You have the dog tags, which are pretty cool. I wouldn't wear them myself. Maybe hang them up in a collection. That's probably what I'm going to end up doing. The pen, which goes with the journal. So all of this goes together. It's nice to have it for writing and things of that nature. The bag, which is probably the crown jewel of this entire thing. The bag itself is nice. You got room for pretty much anything. Books or, you know, whatever the case may be. And then you have the wallet, which I'm not a big fan of this wallet, I'll be honest. I expected something completely different when I heard there was a wallet inside this case. The collectible coin. This is the exclusive collectible. And then finally, and honestly the most disappointing, would be this canteen. I was really, really hoping that this canteen was going to be similar to the one from the Prima Game Guides. So just to kind of do a little comparison, this is the canteen from the $30 box that you get from Walmart. It is plastic all around. And it's for use with water only, quite obviously. And that is all that comes in that particular box. But looking at the canteen, this is the one from the Prima Games deployment kit, which I unboxed. I'll put a link in the description if you guys want to check that out. This thing is super high quality. Completely metal, by the way. Complete metal, comes with its own little cup. Got your handles on there. So you can make your coffee in the morning if you want to. It can go around an open flame if you wanted to. And the carrying case for the canteen actually has a belt loop attached. So I honestly really like the one from the Prima Game Guide more. But for this value, everything that you're getting for 30 bucks, it's really not that bad. I mean, there's a lot of stuff in there. It would make a really nice gift for anybody that's a fan of Call of Duty. It's got the nice bag in there. And I guess if you only use credit cards, you could technically use the wallet. But anyway, guys, that's going to conclude the unboxing for today. If you enjoyed, take a moment of your time to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, I'll see ya. Peace.